When you study the book of Acts, there are two things that stand out: prayer and evangelism. When you study Acts in the context of prayer and evangelism, you discover the preaching of the word, Peter preaching at Pentecost, the proclamation of the gospel through Paul, standing before kings and proclaiming the truth of the gospel. Acts is a prayer book. We call it the Acts of the Apostles, but really it's the Acts of the Holy Spirit through the apostles in a prayer environment. It begins with going to an upper room and praying and waiting until the Spirit came down and moved in the hearts of the disciples, and then people were saved. He preached Jesus, crucified and resurrected. Peter said, "This Jesus whom you crucified, God has made him both Lord and Christ." So why is it important to pray when we preach? Because it was in a prayer environment that the church was birthed. It was in a prayer environment that God gave Peter the words to speak in that short sermon in the book of Acts. It was in a prayer environment of a praying church that planted churches, that spread the gospel around the world, that preached in the cities of the Roman Empire, and ultimately changed the whole empire. So if you want to know why prayer and preaching are important, you cannot read the book of Acts and separate prayer, preaching, and the winning of the lost. It's there. And sometimes we try methods to win the lost. We try to get the hottest type of preaching and we try to add things to it. But in the book of Acts, it was the simple proclamation of the Word of God, of Jesus Christ and His power to change lives out of a praying church. They got Peter out of prison by prayer. Everything you look is birthed in prayer in the book of Acts. When you read Paul's letters, he writes prayers and tells the churches to pray to this end. The exhortation of the church and the edification of the church comes in a prayer environment. It does not come void of prayer. Prayer is not over here in some corner, isolated from everything else that happens. Prayer has to be in the DNA of our preaching, that we pray about what it is that we say and that we ask people to pray with us, so that when the word is preached, the seed does not fall on rocky soil, but it falls on tender, stirred up, tilled up soil so that it bears fruit. Ask people to pray for the preaching of the word. Pray for every man of God that you know that stands up on Sunday and proclaims the Word of God. It will change the proclamation of the Word. It won't make the sermon any different as much as it will make our ears different to hear and to obey what God has said to us.